morning, everyone. I'm glad to welcome Dr. R. Shubha, Head of the Department, CSE, who had been a great support to initiate this webinar. And I welcome our organizers, Mr. Sampath Kumar, Assistant Professor, CSE, and Mrs. Gayatri, Assistant Professor, CSE, and all other faculty members. And now, I welcome our presenters and our student friends and all other attendees who have joined us to enlighten the session. Once again, good evening all. Now, I affably invite Mrs. Gayatri, Assistant Professor, CSE, to initiate this event.
Thank you, Sharmila. Good evening all. On behalf of our management, Sri Ishwar College of Engineering and Department of Computer Science and Engineering, I welcome you all for the Day 4 Student Webinar Series. A college will provide the students with a lot of placement and training activities in order to make the students to be very helpful. From the students' perspective, they all have been thinking of what is being required and how well do we want to perform during our placement. As a part of placement and training, there comes a variety of options to be taken place for the students to develop their skills, that is soft skills, again logical reasoning and programming skills, and also the area of interest. Here our student Sampath Kumar R of for final year CSE got placed in Amazon, going to deliver the webinar on the topic placement and activities or the qualities required for the student to get into it, which is a very needed topic, that is during our virtual online training in this pandemic situation. Before we would like to hear from Sampath, I once again thank you all for a great support and let us motivate our students to grow more higher during their career. Thank you. Now I request Sampath Kumar to take over the session.
Hello everyone, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Yeah. Hello everyone, I am Sampath Kumar, final year computer science student, Sri Ishwar College of Engineering, Coimbatore. And today we are going to discuss about the placement and the qualities needed to get one. Yeah. First of all, I would like to thank the management of Sri Ishwar College of Engineering, Principal Dr. Sudha Mohan Ram, Director Mr. Raja Ram, and the Chairman Mr. Mohan. And I would like to thank my Department of Computer Science and Engineering, and the Head of the Department, Dr. Shubha, and the faculty members of the department. And my special thanks to the organizers of this event, Professor Sampath Kumar, Professor Gayatri, belongs to the Department of Computer Science and Engineering. Yeah. Let us start the session now. So last year at the same time, so I was looking for the placement. So after 1 year, I have attended 25 plus interviews. So with that experience, I think I can share my knowledge on placement and the qualities needed. Yeah. Okay, we can start the session now. So I would suggest you guys to, before you are attending the placement, I would suggest you guys to decide your role first and then prepare for it and then achieve it. Okay, so if you decided your role, means you can prepare specifically, separately for your role, and you can achieve it simply. Yeah. So in our software industry, we have majorly 4 types of roles available: development, quality assurance, operations, and the customer support team. Apart from this, we have many other roles, but basically if you take any software industry, we have this 4 roles. So development, quality assurance, operations, and the customer support. Okay, let me briefly explain what are all these roles and then what are all the qualities needed for this role specifically. Yeah, let us start with development team. So what basically a development team will do? So there will be a project. That project will be splitted into number of modules. If we take a software project, that project will be splitted into number of modules. So each module will be allocated to each of the development team in the software organization, right? So each team will have each module of a project. So if we, you know, each module will be split, and so the each as a task. So each task will be allocated to a person in the team, software development team. So there are number of persons, right? So for each person, each task will be allocated. So this is how basically a development team will work. So let us see the advantages and disadvantages of the development role. Basically, a developer's advantages, they are enough to expertise in only one technology. It is enough. Say for an example, so a developer is working in a company which is using a technology called Java full stack, right? So if an employee is working for 5 years in that company, means so they need to expertise in Java full stack, but they no need to aware the other technologies like Python or .NET or something. But if they have the, if they know one technology, means they can sustain in the industry. It is good to have other technologies, right? So when we, it is the advantage. And if coming to the disadvantages, the flexibility is needed. So we all know the technology is growing day by day, right? So if you are working in a company for 5 years, and you know, as per our example, if you know Java full stack means, your company might think that after 5 years or 10 years, your company might think that the Java full stack, which is old technology, right? So that Java full stack technology may become outdated, right? So the company might think to, you know, upgrade their technology. They might move to .NET or they might move to Python or something. So at that time, a developer is need to flexible to learn the upcoming technology, right? So even though a developer is expertise in Java full stack, which is the outdated technology, they have to learn. They should have the flexibility to learn the new technology that is coming in the market, right? So this is the overview of development role. Let me switch over to the quality assurance role. So quality assurance role, what a quality assurance team basically will do is, development team will develop the modules, will be writing the code and creating the project. So that project will be tested by the quality assurance team. So to test that, to test the product, the quality assurance engineers should need the creative mind, a vast, wide mind. Because, so if we take a website as an example, which is take a website as an our product, so the quality assurance engineer or a team should test each and every functionality of a website, right? So whether it could be a text or text box or a button or a scrolling bar, so whatever it is, so each and every, including the small features, each and every feature have to be tested by the quality assurance team. For that, the quality assurance engineer should write a test plan and the test cases accordingly to test even the small things, right? So let us look into the advantages of quality assurance role. So quality assurance engineers need not to be expertise in the coding. So limited coding knowledge is enough. So they have to adapt a framework. So they have to adapt a limit. They have to adapt a framework which is already written, and they have to write the code using the framework, right? And like developers, quality assurance engineers do not need to write an efficient code, right? It is good to write the efficient code, but it is not needed. Instead of that, they have to write the reliable code, right? So they have to split into modules, and then they have to write the code. So we have manual and automation testers in the quality assurance team. Manual tester does not need the knowledge of coding, but the automation tester still needs the coding knowledge. So they have to automate the test cases based on the framework available, and they have to maintain the code reliability instead of code efficiency. right? So coming to the disadvantages of the quality assurance team, they should work with multiple frameworks. So unlike developers, quality assurance team should work with multiple frameworks. They cannot rely on a single technology or framework. So we have a lot of frameworks like Selenium, Python frameworks, we have Behave, something like that. So if you want to become a quality assurance engineer or part of quality assurance team, you should have the knowledge on multiple frameworks, right? So let me switch over to the other role called operations. So many people might not aware about a team called operations in a software industry, but what basically operations team will do is, developers will be developing the project modules and quality assurance engineer will be testing. So what the operations team will do it, integrate all the modules, operations team will integrate all the modules developed by the development team, and they will be building and they will be deploying it in the server or cloud, right? Say for an example, we will take a Netflix app. So Netflix app will have a separate module for streaming window, a separate module for home, a separate module for a content, right? So what basically operations team will do is, operations team will integrate all the modules and they will be building it. So there are a lot of dependencies between the modules, right? So they have to overcome all those dependencies and they have to build it and they have to deploy it in the server. So what are all the advantages of operations team will be? So they have the entire control of a product, right? So after the development team develops, operations team will have the entire control. If they think like, if they made any mistake, means that will directly affect the customer, right? And the advantage, another advantage is high salary. So comparing to the any other employees in the software industry, operations team will have the higher salary. So why they have given a higher salary means they have to available at any time. This is on this disadvantage. Because so if development team made any mistake means that will be corrected by the quality assurance team. But if operations team will make a mistake means that will be directly affects the customer. Right? So that problem will be immediately resolved. So they have to, operations team members, employees will have to available any time. So they have a high risk if they made any, as I said, if they made any mistake, it will directly affect the customer. Yeah, this is the overview of operations team. Let me switch over to the another important role called customer support. So in any software industry, so there will be a role called customer support. But many people think like customer support is a lower level job. It is not like that. So if you guys are very much qualified in the communication, right? Communication and email writing and content writing, it is the role for you, right? It is the best role for you guys. So here the coding is not needed. 0%, you don't need to write a code for 0%, right? So what is the disadvantage in this? You will have a product knowledge on one product. So let me explain with the example. So you are working as a customer support employee in a product called AWS, Amazon Web Services. So customer support employee will have entire knowledge on AWS. If an AWS, so he will be, or he or she will be knowing about all the knowledge on AWS. But if we want to switch to another company, means, so we don't have any knowledge on the product that is used by the other company. So this is one disadvantage. But how can we, you know, ignore this? Is like, so we can, if we are working in the AWS, means AWS product will be used by many other companies, right? So like Informatica is using AWS, like every company, many other companies are using AWS. So you can easily switch over to the company which uses the AWS, your product which you worked previously, right? So you will get job opportunities in the kind of companies where they follow the AWS, right? So Informatica kind of companies are offering 8 lakhs per annum salary for this customer support role for fresher. So you guys can prefer if you are not well versed in coding and if you are good in communication. Yeah. So these are all the explanation. Let me tell you the qualities needed. So this slide contains the basics of basic qualities, right? So whenever I say basics, so all the things available in this slide should be mentioned, right? So basics will be, so as I have mentioned, four roles, right? So quality assurance, development, operations, and the customer support. For these four roles, these basic things are needed. So in each role, there will be a problem arises. For that, you should have the problem solving capability. So you can improve your problem solving capability by solving puzzles, quizzes, and solving aptitude problems. So you can solve one problem, one puzzle or one problem per day. So that will be gradually increase your problem solving skills. So you can refer Brilliant org. It is an Instagram channel. It is based on mathematics. You can refer this for puzzles. And also we have YouTube channels like Mind Your Decisions and Three Blue and Drone channels. You can also refer these channels for the problem solving skills. Programming skills. So for any role, programming is need. Programming, even though for the customer support role, the programming, you don't need to write the code. You should have the knowledge of programming. So the basic is you should know any one language. So any one language means you should know about the libraries available in that language. So syntax of the language, methods and functions of the language, and the working of a program. Say for an example, we will take a Java program as an example. So in a Java program, where the program starts, where the program ends, so how the program is compiled, how the program is interpreted, you know, so how the, you know, Java code is basically running. So you should have all this basic knowledge. Right? So whenever I say basics, you should have all this knowledge in this presentation. Yeah. Let me switch over to the specific qualities needed for each role. So in this development role, so for you, developers will be handling the projects, right? So they have to split into the project into each of the modules. So for splitting, they need to have object-oriented programming skills, right? So object-oriented programming, data structures, algorithms like searching and sorting, recursion and backtracking, dynamic programming, and all. So developers will have to think logically and they have to solve problems with the data structures and algorithms. So these are all the things needed for the developer. So you can refer the Geeks for Geeks for the algorithms and data structures. When we are studying, preparing for the placement, Geeks for Geeks is the best website, even though other websites are there. So all the concepts, data structures and algorithms are clearly explained in a simpler way. So you can refer Geeks for Geeks for these data structures and algorithms. Yeah. So let me switch over to the topic, another role, quality assurance engineer. So qualities for quality assurance engineering team. Yeah. So the quality assurance team, as I said, there will be a manual tester and the automation tester. So the quality assurance team employee should have both manual testing and automation testing. They should test both, right? So for automation tester, you should have the basics of coding. So whatever basics in the previous slide. And if it is good to have a framework knowledge. So even though the companies are using many frameworks, if you have knowledge on one framework, which is commonly used, Selenium framework, is well and good for your interview. So if you're good to have knowledge on black box testing, white box testing, unit integration, regression, acceptance and performance testing. So what is what? So you have to know what is what these are all testings, right? So when you are writing test plans and test cases, so you should, manual testers will be writing the test cases in the test plan, and the automation tester would have to automate the test cases based on the framework called Selenium or other frameworks used by the software industry, right? So let me switch over to the another role called operations team. So as I said, the operations team is a high salary team. So many people will not know a team called operations. There is a lot of opportunities in the operations team. For that, it is a simple things, Linux commands, shell scripting. So you should have knowledge on what run all the Linux commands available in the available, and the knowledge on shell scripting, shell commands, and also if you have knowledge on network basics, it will be good. So routing, MAC address, IPv4, IPv6 concepts and all. So you can refer data network communication book that was written by Therizon. It will be useful for network basics. Okay. So it is good to have AWS or Red Hat certification for the operations team role. So I have given the link here. You can refer it. So system administrator, system operations administrator. So if you have the certification, the company will definitely hire you in the operations team. You will get the higher salary. Yeah. Then coming to the customer support team. So as I said, there is no specific qualities for the customer support team. So if you have the learning ability towards the product, and if you have the communication skills and good content writing skills, so you will definitely get a customer support job, right? So, and what basically the customer support team will, so you want the qualities needed is, you guys basically think like, so customer support is just speaking on the phone, but it is not like that. So you can clear the trouble tickets, okay? You can handle the trouble tickets raised by the customer through the mail. If you have good content writing skill, you can able to answer the trouble tickets by the mail. So they will be good to write, right? Yeah. So I'm done with the role and the qualities needed. So if you guys have knowledge on these slides, you can clear the first, second, and the third interview rounds, aptitude round, first programming round, and second programming round. So for problem solving and programming and all, you can collaborate with your friends. You can collaborate with your friends. You can discuss as a group. You can work as a group, and you can crack these. So, yeah, I have seen many people like they will be cracking first three rounds easily. Coming to the fourth round, technical HR round, so they will be struggling to present their project that they have done. So we should not blindly explain our project. We have to categorize, we have to structure our project, and we have to explain in a structured manner. So we can explain like, so first we can say the title, use case of our project, so we can compare our existing application and what our project is going to do. And after that, we can explain the block diagram. And if you have time, you can explain about the implementation part and the futuristic things, if any. Right? So let me explain how to explain a project with an technical HR. Yeah. So let me go with an example. So we'll take online election system as an example. So the use case of my project online election system is, it would have candidate registration, document verification module, auto-generated ID and password for candidate and the voters. So how we can compare this project means, so current election system is manual election system. So people have to go to the center, they have to vote, and there are a lot of document verification process and all. But what our system can do is, it is very simple and 5 minutes to 10 minutes of time, right? So this process, all the complex processes are simplified. So this is the comparison of our use case. So our project is online election system. This will do this and all, right? So what are all the entities in our projects? What are all the main things? What and all we can consider as entities, objects in our project. So if an election system means there will be a voter, there will be a candidate. So of course there will be election, and of course there will be a constituency and the parties, parties will have the candidates, right? So how we can explain? So these are all the, if you are given 2 minutes of time, so you can explain like this. So if you have time till 5 to 5 minutes means you can go with the block diagram, right? So how you can explain your block diagram means, so there will be an entity called vote, right? There will be an entity called user. User is nothing but voter. There will be an entity called a candidate and the party, right? Also, there will be a constituency. So these are all the entities. You can take a paper and you can explain with a pencil or pen with the interviewer, right? So you can draw the entities and you can tell the relationship between them. So we can take block diagram or class diagram, ER diagram, anything. I have taken ER diagram here. So say for an example, I will explain only 2 modules. So each election will have many votes, right? So one election can have many votes. So we can tell the quantum-many relationship, right? So each constituency can have number of voters, can have number of candidates. So one constituency can have the many voters, right? So we can explain that like that. So but one user will have only one vote, right? So this is one-to-one relationship. So likewise, you can explain that. So one user definitely will have the only one vote, right? So likewise, you can split up your project. You can draw it as a block diagram and you can explain it to the interviewer, right? So if you have time means, you can able to explain the implementation part, right? So the implementation part will be like your tech stack, the front end, back end, and the frameworks you have used. Front end can be like it can be your HTML, CSS kind of things. Back end can be like jQuery, Java frameworks like Python, behave something like. You can also explain the risks you have faced. So when you are implementing the project, so the syntax might be wrong. You have approached in the project in a, you have explained your project in an inefficient way. So you can explain the risks faced, and you can also, if time permits, you can explain the future ideas that you have. So the modules you have to be added. So as per the requirement, document verification module and auto-generated ID and password, I have not included here. So you can place it in the future ideas. Yeah. So if you explain the project like this, the interviewer will be impressed. So you will get the good impression. So you can easily, impress the interviewer. Yeah. So I think I'm done with my presentation. Yeah. I would like to, explain my personal experience with my company. So I would like to go with my mother tongue because it will be good. So now on the Amazon la 8 months in the internship poirna, so quality assurance technician. So 8 months internship la vandu, so eppdi ella vandu oru project vandu namma vandu oru categorize panni namma testing la irundha. So vandu oru chinna chinna feature ah vandu namma eppdi vandu oru project la test panna mudiyum, evlo vandu namma customer vandu affect agada padi vandu namma eppdi vandu oru project handle panna mudiyum, so appdin solli irundhuchu. So adula vandu risks vandu namma eppdi irukum appdin solli kettinga, so namma vandu deadlines irukum namakku. So இவ்வளோ மாடியூல்ஸ் வந்து நம்ம இந்த டைமுக்குள்ள முடிக்கணும், கஸ்டமருக்கு வந்து நம்ம இந்த இவ்வளோ டெட்லைன் வந்து நம்ம கொடுத்துருக்கோம் அப்படின்னா, ஸோ அந்த டைமுக்குள்ள நம்ம முடிச்சு கொடுக்கணும். ஸோ இவன் வந்து நமக்கு வந்து இந்த டெக்னாலஜி வந்து தெரியல அப்படின்னா, ஸோ நான் வந்து காலேஜ்ல படிச்சது சி ஜாவா, ஸோ கம்பெனியில யூஸ் பண்ணது வந்து பைத்தன். ஸோ பைத்தன் எனக்கு சுத்தமா தெரியாது, ஸோ பட் வந்து எனக்கு டெட்லைன் கொடுத்துட்டாங்க, ஸோ வந்து அந்த டெட்லைனுக்குள்ள வந்து நான் வந்து ப்ராஜெக்ட் முடிக்கணும். ஓகேவா? ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி இருக்கும்போது வந்து நம்ம வந்து பைத்தன் லேர்ன் பண்ணி கத்துக்கிற மாதிரி இருக்கும். ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி கம்பெனில வந்து நிறைய ரிஸ்க்ஸ் இருக்கும், அது எல்லாமே ஹேண்டில் பண்ணிட்டு அதுக்கப்புறம் தான் வந்து நம்ம அப்படிதான் எப்போ நமக்கு கொடுக்குற டாஸ்க் எல்லாமே வந்துட்டு நமக்கு தெரிஞ்சிருக்கும், தெரிஞ்சதாவே கொடுப்பாங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்லி சொல்ல முடியாது. ஸோ நமக்கு மோஸ்டா இப்ப நம்ம காலேஜ்ல படிக்கிறது வந்து இதுவும் வந்து கம்பெனில வந்து யூஸ் பண்ண மாட்டோம். லைக் நம்ம லாஜிக்ஸ் அண்ட் டேட்டா ஸ்ட்ரக்சர்ஸ் அது எல்லாமே வந்து யூஸ் பண்ணுவோம். லாஜிக் எப்படி ப்ராப்ளம் சால்விங் ஸ்கில்ஸ் அது எல்லாமே யூஸ் பண்ணுவோம். பட் வந்துட்டு டெக்னாலஜி வந்து நம்ம அங்க போய் கத்துக்கிற மாதிரி தான் இருக்கும். ஸோ ஃபைனல் இயர்ஸ் வந்து பிளேஸ்மெண்ட்டாக ப்ரிப்பேர் பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கீங்கன்னு நினைக்கிறேன். ஸோ ஹோப் திஸ் வெபினார் இஸ் யூஸ்ஃபுல். ஸோ தேங்க்யூ ஆல் தி அட்டண்டீஸ். Thank you so much. If you have any queries, you can post it in the chat box.
It was a wonderful session. Thank you, Mr. Sampath Kumar. And now it's time for Q&A session. If you have any queries, kindly post it up in the chat box. Mr. Sampath Kumar, here is your question. And the question is, how to face the HR round? Do you have any suggestions?
So, HR one means personal HR or technical HR?
Both.
Both, yeah. So, when the technical HR, you have to showcase your knowledge. So, if you know something, you have to tell that 100%. You have to showcase that knowledge 100%. If you don't know anything, you should say I don't know. Because so if you say Python, if you know Python means you should know everything. So right from the basics to the data structures, algorithms available in the Python, you should know everything in the knowledge. If you say I know Python, you should know 100% Python. If you say don't know, you can say the things you don't know. Yeah, next question.
Thank you. And we have got another question too. And the question is from Surya. And the question is, does operation team job is permanent or what?
Yeah, of course, operations team is the permanent job. So even though the developers and testers are building and testing the product, finally the operations team is going to build and deploy. The customer's direct contact is with the operations team only. So operations team will be deploying in the server. So after the package was developed by the development team, operations team will be deploying it in the server, and that will be used by the customers. Of course, it is a permanent job.
Thank you. And here is a question from Ajay Desigan. And how do you face personal HR round?
Personal HR will basically look into your flexibility. So you are flexible to work. So if you are good in the technical HR would have contacted the personal HR and then would have informed to the personal HR, right? So if you are technically strong, the personal HR just look into your flexibility of in terms of location, work timing, and stuff. So if you are flexible to work or join to the company means, you can easily crack the personal HR.
Thank you. And here is our next question, and the question is from Mr. Rishi. And the question is, in HR round, if the interviewer asks about the project, what is the best way to explain it? Brief it or like the way you said the phases?
Yeah, so we basic if we explain the project blindly, like the without any structure, so this is my project, so this is my, you know, this is the technology I have implemented. So if you say without any structure means, so there will be a mix, right? So without mixing, so if you structure, as I said before, you structure out your project, you know, so previously specified, if you structure out your project and explain, it will look the HR is a good, HR will look you in a better way, right? So your project will be explained in a good way, right? So that the HR will be impressed, you can easily explain your projects to step by step.
Thank you. And here is our next question from Shruti Nandita. It's like, can you share some tips for aptitude training?
For aptitude training. So aptitude training, it is aptitude is a basic for all the companies, right? So you can look into the indiabix.com. It is a good website, and our college will train you in the aptitude in a very better manner. All the topics that will be asked in an interview and company specific topics will be teached by the our college professors. So if you go through that, if you follow that, you can easily get to know the aptitude problems and tricks and all. So my advice is to follow our college aptitude training regularly and solve the problems given by the aptitude trainers.
Thank you. And here is your next question. And the question is, can you share some tips for getting into Amazon as software development engineer?
Yeah, becoming a software development engineer in Amazon is very easy. So provided if you have knowledge on the, if you have deep knowledge on object-oriented concepts, data structures and algorithms. As I said before, if you know all these three things, you can easily get into Amazon. There are many other openings in Amazon for SDE role. So you can apply, you can directly go for a walk-in and you can apply and you can get placed.
Thank you. And here is your next question. The question is, how can we develop ourselves to answer the questions to the interviewer in his or her expected manner?
Yeah, expected manner. It is, again, it depends on the interviewer, right? So we if we have good technical skills, we know, and communication skills, we no need to bother about the HR who is asking for the question, right? So even though the HR is in a good mindset or not, even not, so if we showcase our skill in a structured manner, if you showcase our technical skills and our interpersonal skills in a good manner, so HR will really impressed and you can easily crack the questions.
Thank you. And here is your next question. The question is from Kritika. Question is, data structures, algorithm and object-oriented programming, is that learning all those is enough to get into Amazon?
Yeah, of course, data structures, algorithms and object-oriented analysis, object-oriented concepts is enough. Yeah, because added to that, you should have the problem-solving capability. So as I mentioned in this PPT, so algorithm means you should know all the algorithms, right? So right from backtracking, dynamic programming, searching, sorting, BFS, and data structures in the sense tree, graph. So all the data structures and all the algorithms and the object-oriented concepts is needed to become a developer, basically.
Thank you. And here is your next question, and it is a suggestion from Mr. Surya, and it is like, tell us how to prepare for their placement, like how can we get prepared ourselves?
So basically, for preparing the placement, if you know programming means, you can, if you find any some new logic means, you can discuss with your friend, you can discuss with your group, right? So as I said before, for the preparing basics and problem solving, so if you get to know any new quiz or new puzzle, if you discuss with the people around you, group of people around you, they will suggest some ideas. So that problem solving skills, you solved in one method, your friend will solve in another method. So there are a lot of ideas will be there. So with that, you can get one idea to solve the problem efficiently. So if you prepare as a group for the placements, if you help your friends, you will both get helps so that you can easily prepare, easily crack the interviews.
Thank you. And here is our next question from Ms. Kamali. And she is asking you to share some tips to get into IBM. Adding to that, she is also asking whether programming knowledge is enough or not. Is programming knowledge is needed?
Yeah, for IBM is a very big company. So as I said before, there are a lot of roles, right? So development, quality assurance engineering, and operations team, and the customer support team. So you decide your role. So based on that, you have to, based on the role, the programming is needed or not. So if you choose development, you need programming. If you choose customer support, it does not need programming.
Could you share some tips to get into IBM?
Yeah, tips is not based on the company actually. It is based on the roles. So we cannot say tips to join specific companies, right? So I can say the tips for job role specific.
Thank you. And here is a question from Mr. Surya. And the question is like, how do you get placed into Amazon? Could you explain us?
So Amazon, so I had 4 rounds. So since it is a quality assurance team's interview, so first round was basic aptitude and the programming. And the second round was written programming. So all the questions were basic. And the third round is writing the test plan and test cases for the, a product. So say for an example, if you have taken a water bottle, you should write the test case for a water bottle. Like, so how the weight is. So if it is a 1 liter water bottle means, so will that water bottle contain 1 liter or less than that or more than that? So you have to write the test cases in the third round. And final round is about the project that I have done. And stuff. So this is the interview was easy. So hope you guys can also get placed in Amazon.
Thank you. And here is your next question: is thorough knowledge of subject is enough, or kind of projects to be done in that domain to be get placed?
Subject knowledge is must, right? So to get placed, the subject knowledge is must. So in case of project. So it is, it is good to have one project, at least one project, right? So one project is needed. Yeah.
Thank you. And where is your next question too? How to develop our own area of interest? Do you have any suggestions?
So basically, I won't like, games or watching series kind of things and all. So it is my need, right? So it is my need to get placed in a company. So I have to get placed so that my interest was developed. So I have to develop my interest, right? So if I want to get placed in a company means, so I should know something, right? I should know some technical skills, right? So if we have actually need, so the interest will be developed by ourselves.
Thank you. And here is the next question from Mr. Surya. And he's asking you to share all your failures in many interviews that you have faced. And how did you turn it out into a success one?
Yeah, when I am attending the company's interview, so I have attended a product company, a very good product company as my first interview. So in that, final round. In the final round, I was not aware of implementing the object-oriented concepts. So after post which, so I learned object-oriented concepts. So my area of interest and my strength is object-oriented programming and develop analysis. So that I made it as a strength, you know. So, you know, I don't know how to explain a project and I don't know, you know, how to showcase my skills. So after that, I done a project I have done a project with the Ampis of Technologies. So in that, I learned how to explain a project and how to showcase our skills to the interviewer. So by doing the project, I developed myself and I made it. Yeah.
Thank you. And here is our next question from Kausalya. The question is like, how can we clear GD round, group discussion round?
So group discussion round is basically based on the communication, right? So it will not be in the many of the product companies, it will be in the service companies. So to crack the group discussion rounds, so your point should be clear, right? So what you are saying is your point should, you should clearly tell your point, the first one, and you should not oppose the opponent, right? So you should oppose in such a way that it can be like that, that can be like that, and you should oppose in a polished manner if you are opposing, and you should help your friend, you should help the other contestant to if they are struggling. So if you clearly mention your point, if you oppose in a polished way, if you help your friend, if you help another person if they're struggling, so you can easily crack the group discussion.
Thank you. And here is your next question. What kind of tips or advice you can give to our current final year students so that they can become a successful software engineer?
Yeah, to become a successful software engineer, so basically people will be, you know, when I was preparing for the interview, so I thought like even if it's a developer or a tester, so whatever the role is, so I was, you know, I was accepted. But if you guys wish to, if you guys decide your role and prepare for that role, and if you become a role that you wish, so it will be good, right? So if you guys prepare for the developer means, you should definitely get some knowledge to get into it, at least to get into a and some other fields, right? So if you have aim to become a role, so you should definitely achieve it. So you will have that knowledge, you will have that fire in you to which will push you to achieve your goal. So keep a goal and achieve it.
Thank you. And here is your next question. Like, how other batch students, like students from Department of EZ, EEE, might get into our software companies? What is your opinion?
Yeah. So this webinar is for computer science students. For EZE and other stream students, the basics of programming is the other students, because the interviewers will be expecting more from the expecting less from the other stream of students. So that if you have a basic knowledge, that basic slide, Anything else?
Thank you, Mr. Sampath Kumar. That is a wonderful session. Thank you a lot. And now, I wholeheartedly invite Ms. Gayatri, Assistant Professor CSC, to deliver a lot of thanks.
Thank you, Shamila. Actually, today's session was a very awesome one, and we have been started with number of roles, different roles in our software industry, and also the explained in a very consistent way of its qualities required for each of these roles. And when it comes to the project, how we need to present our project in a structured manner, that is also very nice to our interviewers. And also answered very well for all the questions posted by our student friends. I would like to appreciate Sambath that came as a volunteer to give this kind of webinar to our student friends. I wholeheartedly thank our management, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, to give us an opportunity to conduct such a wonderful student webinar session. For our students to explore their ideas and share their knowledge and also their experience to other student friends. Once again, I thank you all for your active participation. I would require the same support from all of you for the other days too. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
So let me share a link for this PPT in the chat box. You can get it from there.
Also, the feedback link has been posted in the chat box. You can just click on that link to submit your feedback form. Now, Sambath, do you have anything to share to group?
Yeah, I have shared the drive link of the PPT. Yeah, that's it.
Okay. Yes, you can copy it through that link. I hope you all have copied the drive link and also the feedback link so we can end our session. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you all.